Hey everyone, your host Jeremy Slate here, and welcome back to the Command Your Brand podcast, the show where we talk to visionaries, founders, and people that are doing incredibly big things, world-changing, game-changing things. And we're here in the new studio, which I absolutely love the sound in, so I'm very excited about that. If you're watching the video, you'll notice the background isn't quite like we'd like it yet. It kind of is just hanging there. It's actually a little bit too big for the room, so we have new ones ordered, and apparently they take a little bit of time to come, so we're waiting on those, using these temporarily. So, but we have an awesome guest with us today. We have Oy Dobie, and she is the founder of Project Who Am I, and she's really helping teens and young adults to figure out what they want to do with their life. By actually exploring, by actually looking, by actually figuring things out, because she had a realization in her work life that she doesn't want other people to have, you know, later in life. She wants them to have it much earlier in life. So they actually do things they want to do and explore things they want to explore and have a life of purpose and impact. So without further ado, let's get into this interview with Oy Dobie of Project. Hey, what is up, everybody? Jeremy here. And guys, I'm very interested to talk to today's guest as we have Oy Dobie with us today. And she's really helping people to choose their careers, you know, in an area of life where you're not really sure and you're trying to figure things out, because she was there too. And being somebody that I've been there and trying to figure that out, this is a really, really important thing. Oy, thank you so much for hanging out with me today.
Thanks for having me, Jeremy.
So I want to talk a little bit about your story, because you had a career that was going, you had gotten a promotion, and it seemed like it was a lot of what you wanted to do, but you did some reflection and changed your mind on that. So tell us a little bit about your story.
Yes. My story is really a story of being an achiever. That's my number one strength, is I love to achieve things, and it just gives me a lot of satisfaction to set goals and achieve them, and then move on to the next thing. And that worked really well in my career in corporate America, because it was just like, what's next? You know, mm-hmm. What opportunity is next? What responsibility is next? And I would just take it. But one time I did get passed up for promotion. And as those events happen, you know, it makes you kind of go through a roller coaster of emotions, you know, self-doubt, a little bit of anger. And then it caused me to calm down and really self-reflect. You know, that last piece of emotion that I had was, you know, I don't need this company to feel worthy. And so then it made me think about, well, what do I need to feel worthy? And it made me start to think about all those things that are important to ask yourself. So I started to do that self-reflection.
What things were you asking yourself? I'm curious.
I think the number one question that I had for myself that I've never asked myself in 20 plus years of career is, how do I want to make an impact on this world? I mean, I know for us, for our younger generation, that is probably a common question that comes up. Mm-hmm. But, you know, being 46, for some reason, that question never came up. So that was the number one question for me, is how do I want to make an impact on this world? And that was a big question.
You know, that's really interesting, because I know I'm in my mid 30s. And when I was 24, my mom had a really bad stroke, and that made me kind of look at a lot of what I was doing and ask myself that same question. And I guess I'm curious, from your perspective, why is that something that we never asked ourselves in the past, but it now seems like something that's asked quite often? Like, where do you think that shift was?
You know, I think the shift probably just has to do with more of a, you know, that's a really good question. I think the reason why we didn't ask that question previously is a lot to do with just, you know, doing things based on expectation, right? And whether it be your parents' expectation and your grandparents' expectation, friends and family expectation, just, you know, generations of expectation drive a lot of the things we do in society. And I think society as a whole is starting to wake up a little bit, as I would call it, and pick up our heads and say, is this really what we should all be about? And I, you know, and I think now that you ask me that, I think a lot of the reasons why people are asking themselves this question or even considering it is, I would say, you know, due to the boom of the internet and the kind of the exposure to so much more in the world than previously, you know, you mm-hmm. have a lot more exposure, it causes you to see things that you've never seen before. And so thus ask different questions.
You know, that's interesting. Like my career wouldn't even have existed, like I think 5 years ago. So it's kind of wild to look at that. And one of the things that you make a really interesting point there about, like, I don't want to disappoint people, you know, there's maybe this plan that's laid out for me and things like that. So I guess, how does a teen or a young adult approach that then? Like, how do you decide what you want and what you want to do with the same time? Like, you know, you're worried about upsetting your family. You're worried about letting your parents down. You're worried about what other people want for you. Like, how do you, I guess, make that decision and actually explore what you want younger in life and not kind of go down this path, not looking at that?
You know, I think a couple things, and this requires a lot of self-reflection on the team, but, you know that the people, typically the people that are, that you're surrounded with are people that love you. And they want the best thing for you, and they want it for based on their own perspective, right? Mm-hmm. So each person in this world has lived their life or is living their life through a variety of different situations and perspectives and influences, and that all forms who they are as a person, how they think, and they're gonna want to help you grow up to be an adult and want you to be in the best spot possible based mm-hmm. on their experiences and who they are, mm-hmm. which, you know, again, from the place of love. And so I think as a teenager, you have to realize everybody wants to help me and they have a different perspective, but really let's absorb what they're truly trying to do and maybe peel some of the other stuff out, get at the good nuggets, and then, you know, base it off of you yourself as a person.
I think that can be a tough balance though too, right? Because I don't know about you, but like at 19, I thought I could conquer the world, and, you know, in some ways I can, but also at the same time, we don't have like that life experience yet too. So there's kind of this balance of, you know, I found a little bit of life experience. I don't want to see my later years, like I'm only in my 30s, but like I found some life experience, but also balanced out with, at the same time, like exploring what you want to do, right? I remember when I first started, you know, my entrepreneurial journey at 25, for the first 3 years of it, my dad was like, do you need money? Like, how's it going? How are things happening? And it took like 3, 4, 5 years for it to work out before it was kind of like that viewpoint shift. So I guess mm-hmm. when you're looking at that, how do you balance out what you want to do with also at the same time, you know, needing that life experience in some ways?
You know, I think there's a couple things, you know, balancing what you want to do. First, you have to understand that, right? What mm-hmm. what do you want to do? And then second, you have to have the courage to take the next step. It's one step at a time. And, you know, the more you do, the more you'll experience mm-hmm. and the more you'll discover, is this really the right path for me or maybe not? But it starts out with two things. It's first, you got to understand, you know, who you are and what you want, or, you know, the direction you want to go, and then have courage to do it. And then thirdly, take that step.
Well, Oy, one of the things that you've spoken about here repeatedly is the idea of reflection and looking at things. And I think when you're a teen or you're somebody that's just starting college or things like that. And I remember back to those days, like, okay, I need to get this community service thing. I need to get this organization. Like, you try to store up all these things so that you're a better applicant for college or you're better for the career that you want in 5 years. So you kind of fall into this trap of just staying busy to stay busy, and you don't have that space to reflect.
Yeah.
From your perspective, how do you create that space? Because you need to have that in order to look at these things.
Right. You know, and as a teen, that's hard because society, us as parents, we push that staying busy. You know, part of it is, hey, if they stay busy, they'll stay out of trouble type of thing. But if you're too busy, you know, you don't have the time and space to think. And so I think as a teen, if you are experiencing the situation where you're like, you want to explore things, but you are too busy to do it, mm-hmm. then, you know, just like anything, reach out to your parents and say, hey, mom and dad, I want to do this, but I don't know how because I'm too busy. And, you know, and think through what are some of the things that you're busy with, do an inventory of that and say, what are the, you know, are those things important to me to help me discover myself? Or are they just stuff that, you know, I feel like I should do because I'm expected? And then sit down with your parents and have that, you know, very frank conversation about that. And as parents, you know, we have to understand that we shouldn't overload our kids, our teens, ourselves mm-hmm. with just a bunch of busy work, right? Have time and space to do things and think about things that you are interested in, explore. So it's the combination of the teen raising their hand and asking for help and the parent just realizing, you know, what is the situation for our family?
You know, it's interesting because I feel like as parents, we could definitely do a better job with that, right? Because I feel like we always say the communication line's open, but it's not always open. And I think it is important to help our kids understand like, hey, like whatever you have to say, I'm here to listen to that. Because without open conversations, you're creating more fear for the kid and you're kind of making it so you can't really handle conversations. So it is important to keep that open, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The other thing too is, you know, if you as a parent believe in exploration and want to have your kids start to explore, your teenagers start to explore, I think the number one tip is you yourself start to explore. Mm-hmm. Set that example, lead by example, and then share with your teen your exploration activities, you know, kind of what are you doing to explore? What's the thought process that comes with that? How's that going? Is it something that you're enjoying in this exploration? Or is it something that you're like, oh, that wasn't exactly what I expect it to be? And so just leading by example, I think is huge, because if your kids see you do it, then they learn from you as far as what to do and what not to do. And even if you make mistakes, they realize that because they're like, I'm not going to do it that way.
Well, Oy, you mentioned a few moments ago about the idea of, you know, like we're looking for careers, looking what we're going to be doing. And I there's definitely some mistakes you can make in looking for your career and searching. So I guess when you're looking at that, what are the most common mistakes when you're helping your teen search for a career? Because I think it can be difficult. Sometimes you're pushing them into, you know, what you couldn't do or, you know, what you want for them rather than exploring what they want. So I guess, how do you, you know, what's the biggest mistake around that?
I think the biggest mistake around exploring careers in my mind is that people are after the career. You know, mm-hmm. they're focusing on the career. Okay, what do you want to be when you grow up? And then they fixate on these various careers and then they start going down that path. And then they go, okay, what skills are required for XYZ career? You know, how do we build those skills? And really, we just need to stop doing that. Because again, it could be a lot of times fitting a square peg into a round hole. First, you should focus on the person. Mm-hmm. What are they really good at? What are they interested in? And then once you understand those fundamental aspects of your teen, then start exploring careers that fit into that. And that way you're really, you know, putting the right fit together.
Do you think we ask our teens and young adults to find careers too early? Because I know, at least for myself, like, and I don't know if anybody should do the college experience quite like I did. Like I kind of came in with an ambiguous major and I'm like, all right, I'm going to take that because it sounds interesting. I'm going to take that because it sounds interesting. I got to my senior year and realized I could triple major. So I did it. Like when you're looking at it, like, do we ask them to decide too early? And should there be more, I don't know, like, should there be like a time between high school and college, or like, what should that look like?
You know, I think it depends on the 16. You know, I know plenty of students who know right from when they are 8 years old, just because it's so innate in them, you know, the things that they are passionate about and interested in, and they're very like driven, just, you know, it's just gung-ho everything, right? And they follow that career path throughout their life, and they're perfectly happy and it's fulfilling. And other teens, they like a variety of things. And so that exploration is really important. So, you know, to answer your question, you know, unfortunately it really depends.
Yeah.
And, you know, for your example, you know, triple major, my gosh.
it wasn't planned though. I got to the end. They're like, wow, you have an obsessive amount of credits. Cause like I went to a school here in New Jersey where the price for 12 credits and 18 was the same. I'm like, oh, so I'll just take a whole bunch of classes. And they got to the end. They're like, all right, so you take a couple capstones and we're good to go here.
Right. And you know, the thing to consider about that is, you know, obviously cost, right? So in your example, it didn't cost you anymore to take those classes. So if you have the energy and interest and ability to do it, you might as well.
Right.
But some people, you know, they that would be a lot, right? To take that many classes and absorb all that information. I'm guessing you, one of your strengths is you're a learner, because if you're
I'm weird. I can sit there in a class and I'll remember everything the teacher said to me. I'm just weird like that. I just have a really good memory, and it served me in life.
Wow, that's amazing. So going back to the question, you know, I think it just depends on the kid.
Mm-hmm. Well, that makes sense. Well, we've been talking a lot about what we're deciding in life. We're talking a lot about where we're going. So one of the biggest things you're working on right now is called Project Who Am I? Yes. So Oy, what is that? Tell us a little bit about that.
The Project Who Am I program is an online program that we offer. It's a self-discovery program, and we gear it towards junior and seniors in high school, because they're at that stage where they really need to start thinking about these things. And they're very much thinking about, you know, what does life look like after high school? What post-secondary options do I have? Which routes do I want to go? And so this program is typically a four-week program. We have four steps within the program, and we advise to do it, you know, one per week, but sometimes people take a little bit longer due to, you know, busyness and vacations and whatnot. But that is what Project Who Am I is.
Wow, that is super cool. And I'm excited to learn more about it. So, well, Oy, I've really enjoyed this conversation today. For people listening, if they want to find out more about you and find out more about Project Who Am I, where should they go?
They should go to projectwhoami.com/discover.
Very cool. Well, Oy Dobie, thank you so much for hanging out with me today.
Thanks, Jeremy.